What's up, guys? This is Will Schusterick. As promised, I'm showing you what was in my bag for the 2014 United States Championship. My bag changes based on the course, the tournament, and what Prodigy has released recently. And what I've came up with for playing the Winthrop Gold Course is usually pretty standard compared to my last couple years that I've played the tournament. I like to keep it fairly simple. I don't throw a lot of discs during the tournament. I've probably threw about 6 or 7 different molds, usually more overstable compared to understable, but we'll get right into it and I'll show you what I was throwing. My main putter was a 350G PA3. After my last putt on hole one, I rode on it a big 3-time. I probably won't use this putter. I'll probably hang this up, maybe frame it, and keep it for a long time. But I have 2 extras in my bag. I don't use these for anything else besides warming up in the morning. For mid-ranges, I have a 400 series M1. I only threw this disc at Winthrop if it was a lot of wind. Usually on the last day, I think I threw it once or twice, but overall in the tournament, I threw it less than 5 times. So this is an example of not throwing an overstable disc on the course. The 750 M4 just came out by Prodigy in this new plastic. I threw this disc off the tee on hole 8 every single round, and I threw it out to the left with a flat to slight anhyzer, and it would fade slightly to the right. And besides that hole, I don't think I threw it for anything else. And it's a nice slight hyzer, flip up to straight, and then slow fade to the right. This is also a 750 M4, and this one's a little bit more overstable than the previous one. And I throw this disc if it's a little bit windier, and I think I threw this disc once or twice. This one doesn't fade right as well as the as hard as the previous M4. Likes to stay straight. This is the new 750 M3. This is the one I got from Paul Uliberry. I traded him one of his favorite discs for this. And this disc likes to fade left when the M4 likes to keep going right. So I threw this disc maybe a handful of times as well. And once again, I started out with a slight hyzer. It goes pretty straight and then finishes to the left. So this is probably my favorite mid-range to throw. I threw the 750 M2 a good amount out there. And this one's fairly beat up. I like to throw it with a slight hyzer and it goes straight and then finishes straight. And I can throw it with a slight anhyzer and it'll fade right with no hard fade to the left. And I threw this disc off the tee pad on hole 16 a good amount, and it worked well on a couple other slight anhyzers or hyzer straight with no fade at all. This was probably my most thrown mid-range at the tournament. For fairway drivers, I carried 3 750 H1s. And in my book, the H1 is more comparable to a fairway driver than it is a driver. It's a little bit faster than the F-series discs. The H1 is a really overstable disc. It's really good for headwinds, really good for spike hyzer shots. And for me, I can throw it as hard as I want with a slight anhyzer turn, and it'll come out of it no matter what wind it is. I threw this disc probably 60% of the time while I was on the course, because I know every single time within a 10-foot radius where I could throw it. So my upshot towards the basket on hole 5, my upshot towards the basket on hole 9, and hole 10 are a couple of the areas where I threw the H1. And this H1 was probably my most thrown overall. The next fairways that I have are the F2 and 750. I don't think that I threw this disc at all during the tournament. It's one of those courses that you're either going to be throwing a mid-range off the tee to a shorter area, or you're going to be throwing a driver to try to get towards the basket. And for me, the fairway didn't really fit into my bag, but I had it in there just in case the wind came up or I was in a different situation off the tee that I wasn't prepared for. And another disc that I didn't throw too much off the tee was the 400 series F3. And once again, it just didn't fit into the course or my game plan, but I had it in there just in case something came up. in my throwing putters for the week. I had two 300 series PA3s. I numbered them on the back, number one and two. And number one was one that I put into my bag first. This one is a little bit more understable than the number two. And I threw this PA3 on hole one and chained out for an ace. And it's also the disc that I threw to park the second playoff hole. This was one of my favorite discs over the weekend. The number two 300 series PA3 had a little bit of a hyzer finish to it. And I threw this off the tee pad on hole 13 and a couple of my upshots when it got a little bit windy. And this disc right here really saved the whole tournament for me. Because of the really grippy plastic, it wouldn't skip at all. So whenever it came to land, it sat in bounds and then wouldn't skip or move in any direction. I highly suggest the 300 series PA3 to throw. One of my favorite discs in my bag is a really beat up PA4. And I use this disc for rollers or 100 foot upshots or 200 foot upshots that I just want to go dead straight. I can release it just with a slight hyzer, and it'll hyzer flip at about 100 feet if I'm throwing it from 200 feet, and it'll glide right towards the basket. I feel pretty confident if I'm trying to make it from 150 feet with this disc. I have a 350G PA1 with my Prodigy disc custom stamp. I threw this disc off the tee on hole 17. The third round, after I went OB on my first shot and got in bounds, and then during the last round, I got it in bounds on hole 17 as well. And that was the only time I threw this disc. This disc has been in my bag for probably 3 months now. And it saves me a lot of strokes. It goes fairly straight with a slow fade to the right since it's beat up. And feels really nice in the hand. The last putter in my bag is the 750 PA1. And this disc is really overstable. And thrown with a slight hyzer, it will do no turn at all. It'll just stay on the hyzer line the whole way with a fade pretty hard to the left. And this disc really came in handy when it got windy out. And if there was any type of headwind and I needed a putter shot, this was the disc. The final few discs in my bag were my drivers. And one of my most thrown discs throughout the week was the 400G D1. And the D1 is a really overstable distance driver. And this one is slightly beat up, so I know how consistent it's going to be. I've had it in my bag probably for 2 months now. I can throw it with a slight hyzer. I know it's not going to flip over at all. And I threw this disc off the tee on a lot of the longer holes, like hole 5 off of the tee box or hole 10 off of the tee box towards the basket. I have another 400G D1. This one is a little bit more beat up, and this one for me will go out to about 400 or 450 feet and stay a little bit straighter than the yellow 400G D1 I have in my bag. I didn't throw the 400G D3 too much during the week. For me, it's more of a pure distance disc or something that has a controlled slight turnover to it at the end. So coming down the stretch or throughout the week, I didn't throw the 400G D3 too much. Because for me on the course, I don't throw a lot of long, slowly turning shots. The 750 X1 is one of my most thrown discs on the Winthrop course. For me, I know exactly where this disc is going to land no matter how I throw it or no matter what the wind situation. So this was a really consistent disc in my bag. I threw this disc on my upshot a lot on hole 5 if there was a lot of wind, on my tee shot on hole 6. Or if I needed some type of spike hyzer around the 400 foot range. Highly suggest getting an X1 in your bag. This is really consistent disc. And then the last disc I had in my bag was the 400 series D4. And this is my roller disc or soft driver that will hyzer flip at about 300 feet. And for me, I think I threw this disc once or twice. I didn't throw many rollers on the course this weekend. I planned to on hole 8. But I wasn't in a good situation off the tee either day. So this disc is really consistent for me as a roller. I can throw it really hard with a slight hyzer, and it will go to about 400 or 500 feet and then flip over to the right. And that's all the discs I have in my bag. And we're going to continue with the 20 questions that were posted on my fan page. So here are the questions that I got asked on my fan page. Thanks everybody for posting a question. I picked 20 of the questions to answer. And if you guys have something that I didn't answer, please comment below and I'll try to get back to you. The first question was, do I have a competitive advantage at USDGC versus other majors or tournaments? And coming into the USDGC, compared to the previous years, I try to prepare as much as possible. I want to know all the areas on each hole, about the distance, about what disc I'm going to throw. And whenever I know that the conditions on the course are going to be different than normal, I want to go out there and practice and see what landing area I'm going to be in. So for example, hole 5, it was windy throughout the week. So I tried to go there and practice when it was really windy to see what I would throw, to see what I would do off the tee pad, to see where my second shot would land, and to see how to get over to the basket. So I would do that basically on every hole and try to have a game plan going into the day if the tournament day was that windy. The next question is, what is the key to winning the USDGC? And for me, the key to winning USDGC is keeping your drives in bounds and trying to play the most consistent shot on each hole. There are a lot of shots throughout the week where I told myself that I will do okay taking a par on the hole, and my game plan for that certain hole was to just not go over par throughout the week. So for example, hole 12, if I was not in a good position to go for the birdie, I would lay up to the left and then lay up to the basket to take a par. Because I know if I go for it on my second shot and I wasn't in a comfortable area, then I could end up taking a bigger number. The third question is, how do you keep your head in the game after a bad shot? And there were a couple times in the first round where I had a bad shot and I told myself that we have 3 more rounds to go, and you really have to leave your bad shots behind and really focus on your next shot, or otherwise you're going to be thinking about the next shot more than you did the previous hole. The fourth question is, what was going through your mind after 18's missed putt and then going on to hole 1 in the playoff hole? And going through my mind was trying to stay calm and try to forget about the missed putts, because everybody has missed a putt that short in their life. It just happened to me to be on the biggest hole of the tournament. And going into hole 1, I just wanted to focus and really follow through with my putting and really focus on executing the shot. The fifth question is, what do you know about the soon-to-be-released Prodigy H2? And I practiced a little bit with the H2 during the week. I did not throw it in the tournament. I tested it a little bit with Phil Arthur, and I really like the H2. It's a little bit of a less stable H1, and I'll be able to throw it into a moderate headwind with a flat shot, and it's going to be able to go farther than the H1 with still a consistent hyzer finish. And I'll actually post a review of the disc later this week on my YouTube channel. The sixth question is, what is your favorite Bearded Brothers bar flavor? My favorite is coconut mango. The seventh question is, was Chipotle a big player in your USDGC success? I would say yes. I eat Chipotle at least 5 times a week. The eighth question is, what are your goals for 2015? And my goals for 2015 right now are to really focus on the bigger tournaments and hopefully bring home a world championship. The ninth question is, what has been your biggest battle on tour? And one of the biggest battles, I think I can speak for any touring disc golfer, is to find the time to relax along with the time to get to the tournament that you're going to. Because it takes about, sometimes you have to go from one side of the country to the other, and when you get there, you've been driving for 30 hours and the tournament is in 3 days and you have to play 2 different courses. So it's tough to find the time to relax and let your body recoup all the energy that you lost after driving that far. The 10th question is, what have you learned about your game and what have you done to adjust to it? And I wouldn't necessarily say I've learned any type of skill. I would say that I've learned a lot mentally about the game. I've learned how to put some bad holes behind me and really focus on the few holes coming up that I have left in the round. And I've really realized in my disc golf game that bad shots are going to happen. We're all human, and it's just a matter of focusing on the next shot and making up for the bad shots. The 11th question is, do you want to see any rule changes for next year? And the only rule change that I can think of is the 2-meter rule, and I'd like to see that completely taken out of the game. The 12th question is, there were a few holes where you clearly drove shorter than the rest of the group to have a longer approach. Why did you do that? To me, it's all about the game plan for the course. So if I have to lay up to a shorter area to be in a more comfortable range to go for the basket, then that's what I told myself I was going to do. So I tried to stick to my game plan. For example, hole 8, I threw a mid-range off the tee and was 100 feet short of the out of bounds because I know I was in a certain area where I could go for the basket, a lot more comfortable throwing a little bit harder of a mid-range instead of trying to go for it with a shorter sidearm or a putter shot. The 13th question is, what Prodigy disc released this year helped capture the title for you? And for me, based on the Winthrop course, I threw the H1, the X1, and the PA3 more than any other disc. Mostly because the X1 and H1 are so overstable and predictable, and the PA3 for my putter. The next question is, what grip do you use for putters, mids, and drivers off the tee pad? And anything over 250 feet, I usually grip it with a power grip. All my fingers underneath the rim, except for the pointer finger. A lot of people think that for a power grip, you have to clench all the way down. But for me, my three fingers are underneath, and then the front finger barely goes over the rim. The 15th question is, what is the toughest hole at Winthrop this year? And for me, the toughest hole is hole 11. Because it doesn't play very well for a backhand upshot. So I tried to play hole 11 for a par throughout the whole week. And I think I was 2 or 3 over going for par. And that was one of the holes that I tried to go for a little bit more out of my game plan. And it bit me more than it helped me. The next question is, what shoes did you wear throughout the week? And I wore a Nike Trail Running Wild Horse. The 17th question is, what state is your favorite to play disc golf in? And I would say either Portland, Oregon, or in Vermont. And I've only played one course in Vermont, but it was amazing. The 18th question is, what do you do other than play disc golf? And other than disc golf, I like to mountain bike. I actually started bringing my bike around with me on tour to do something other than disc golf throughout the week. And besides play disc golf, I talk about disc golf or think about playing disc golf. The 19th question is, did you get jitters walking up to hole 17? And I got a little bit of jitters. It was more of being nervous that I wanted to get in bounds so bad. And I really focused this year on executing the shot, and I really took my time on 17 and felt confident compared to previous years. The last question is, how did your caddy help you on the course? And my caddy helped me in a lot of different ways. When it was supposed to rain in the morning, he went to the course and checked out where the wet spots were going to be and gave me a heads up on if there were going to be any puddles throughout the course and the different landing areas where I was at. He took the caddy book and marked down different spots where I landed throughout the week and told me the distance and kept a record of them. So during the fourth round on hole 13, he could tell me what I did the first round, what disc I threw, and what I need to do to have the same success that I did. What's up, guys? This is Will Schusterick. I'm here to show you what was in my bag for the 2014 United States Championship. Prodigy disc has came out with a lot of discs this year. And I forgot what I was going to say.